You are, so you're at the way, you're doing the waste management, obviously.
Are you, gotta you guys going to come out?
We're thinking about Saturday, right?
It's crazy.
Yeah, we're thinking about Saturday.
That's a good day.
Yeah. And then, so how does, like, waste management to me, growing up here especially.
Last year.
What's that?
He hit one last year. You got one last year, didn't you?
Got one what? Hole one?
Yeah.
No, that was Sam Ryder.
Oh, shit.
That's crazy. That's just us not doing our homework. Because I was sitting with Will there being like, damn, did he really get a hole in one? But that, like, how does the waste management, like, how is it different from things like Augusta and, like, other places? Because it seems like it literally is out of, like, Happy Gilmore.
Oh, it's, yeah, it really is. Shooter McGavin would struggle here. So this I put in context. They don't tell you exactly how many people come through the gates, but I know roughly. So on a given, even a good golf tournament day, like I would say Farmers Insurance 2 weeks ago, final round probably had,
that's where he made his bags,
25,000-30,000 people.
Yeah.
Which feels like a lot at a golf tournament. It's spread out, but it feels like a lot. Saturday at the waste management this week, we'll probably have 250,000 people. It's like holy the top shit. 5-6 sporting event in a day. And it's all week. I mean, yesterday's Monday. It's the first day where the course is open to practice, or sorry, for the fans. But typically, even some of the events don't even open. And, you know, you'll trickle in like a few people. I mean, it's a Monday. People have jobs. I mean, yesterday was still chaos. I mean, it was so many people. So it's different. But my story that explains it, all the golfers call it a party that a golf tournament broke out at.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like if we were here drinking, then all of a sudden you're like, you know, you want to go mess around on that putting green? And like that's like the scale. So my first year ever playing it, I tee off on Thursday off the back nine and 16s, you know, right where like everyone filters in through 10. They walk past 10, past 11, and then filter into 16. And I'm walking off the tee. I got, you know, all my golf clothes on, spikes on, looking like a professional golfer. I got my caddy carrying the clubs, looking like a caddy. And there's a huge line of people on, and there's these two attractive women in front of me. And I say, excuse me. And they're in like heels and dresses and all this shit. And they like look at me and look back away. I was like, excuse me. Like, I'm just trying to get through to the fairway. And she gave me like the, I have a boyfriend look.
Oh no.
And I was like, what the fuck are we doing? Like, I'm working. Like, you're here because there's a golf room. But most of the people don't even, like, that's not even part of it. Like, that's not the vibe. I mean, they have clubs. Like, I have my buddy, I don't know if you guys know he's just Mike now, but Mike Studd and all those guys.
He's one of the boys. Yeah, he's been on the pod a few times. He's
so
awesome.
They rolled through last year, him, Blue, and all the boys. And I got them passes this thing called the Greenskeeper. It's left of 18. And it's like, I've never got to like see anything, but it's kind of like a day club, like outdoor day club. And he's like, hey, I'm going to come out. And I was like, okay, I got you guys these wristbands. And he's like, no, we want to watch you play golf. I said, okay. But I was like, I'll let you know, like, it's really fun, like every day, but especially Saturday. I was like, don't feel obligated to come watch me play, like get in there. So I text him after. I was like, hey man, sorry. Like, I didn't say hi. Like, there's just a lot of people out there, whatever. He goes, he's like, I think he texted me 2 days later. Cause he was like, never even left the Greenskeeper. Like, it was just too much fun. Cause it's just like beer garden. So like, people don't even know there's golf going on. Mm-hmm. 16, you know, but you're there just to boo and get really drunk, and it's different from anything ever, because every other golf tournament is the golf tournament's the priority. In this case, like, that is the alcohol is the priority. It's
it's like a massive
especially that 16th hole, dude. It's crazy. Dude,
it's insane.
How do you get go ahead, Bob.
I was just gonna say, how you feel about everyone starting to throw all that alcohol onto the
onto
the green, like how it was like chaos last
it was a little much. So basically they had to change it this year. I'm not going to go out here and say it's like life and death dangerous, but I mean, people are chucking, you know, cans at you that are full of beer. And like, you know, my buddy Colt got hit with one last year and he's like, didn't feel good. I don't mind it. It's crazy. I like this. This is good for golf. I don't think every week, but it's good for golf. But they are putting cups in solo cups this year. So if you do chuck them, at least like we're not going to get beaned. But I don't know. I like it. It's fun. It's chaos. It's crazy. It's like golf is such like an older person sport that like making it younger and all this and that, whatever. The only problem with last year that we got a little of that, they're starting to do it for anything. Like they crave, it's like
just
you crave
a reason.
The chaos. So yeah. they're like, man, if he makes this 30 footer, we're going to throw it. And then they'll miss. And he's like, if he taps it in though, we'll throw it too. It's like, okay. We're, you know, like make for the hole in one, like go nuts for a bunker shot. You make go nuts, long putt, go nuts. It did feel like last year was kind of like anything we can possibly make happen. and make worth it, we're gonna do it. But it's cool, man. It's a, it's rare. I have my favorite funniest stories from this event, and last year was up there with the most dehumanizing and also kind of funny thing ever. But I was in a late group on Saturday, I think, and we get to 15. I'm making like a little charge, and I don't know why the people who set the tournament up did this, but there's a porta potty like on the tee, and it is really close to a lot of people, and you know, obviously they're quite noisy, and I had a healthy stream that day. So I hop in there and everyone watches me go in there, and I could hear people like, you know, chanting as I'm like in the bathroom, and it's like really uncomfortable. And I get out and I just get like, I mean, they're already standing, but it was still like a standing ovation, like a roar happens as I leave this bathroom. I looked at Joe and I'm like, dude, I don't even feel like a fucking person anymore.
Just for a piss.
Like, thank God I didn't have to take a shit, because like that just would have been a tough one in there. So you have that. I've had my favorite heckles have been at this one. So it's a great event. It's just, it's very different.
Is it, when you're looking at like your first couple of times doing the waste management, is there like a level of FOMO that you had at any point being like, these people are having
every year
an incredible time?
Every year.
I remember like, I don't know about you, but like being on the buses, going to like college football and seeing all these,
oh,
all these people tailgating. You're like, damn, I've never been to a tailgate.
I got to do all the tailgating.
Yeah.
So we roll reverse. It is hard, man. I guess like last year I got all these friends in town, and like one night, you know, like I get invited to go to dinner with like Goff, who I'm buddies with, and Yelich, and all like just like my favorite like coolest athlete friends who we keep up with each other, but I never get to see them because they're busy when I'm not busy, and I'm busy when they're busy, and they're like, man, we're going out to Bottle Blonde tonight. You know, I know it's probably hard, but you want to come? And I'm just like, fuck you, yeah, like I want to go. But and then they're like, no, you're not coming. And I'm like, I know, but like, you just, all the parties are this week and it's so much fun and everyone's out and watching people like just drink while we're all golfing and just seem like truly having the time of their lives while I'm just like wrestling between making bogeys, birdies, and pars. It's just like, it's just not nearly as fun.
Changing diapers.
Yeah.
Now this week, Super Bowl week.
Yeah. Now it's Super Bowl.
It
like,
just makes everything
here,
so much more.
It's just crazier, but I don't know, man. I have FOMO every year at this event, but there have been times like my favorite, like last year's Saturday, my last like five holes is my like one of my favorite things that's happened to me in golf, just because when you do perform in front of all those people, you guys would get this more. We don't get this very often, but it's like the rush of it is, well, you know, it's worth not drinking the beers. But yeah, there's still times where I'm like, God dang, it looks pretty. You know, if I get on a little bogey run, I'm like, I could just be out there right now. Like,
yeah,
full, and I got full access. I got this little credential, gets me everywhere. I could be doing all the coolest stuff, but I don't know. It's a good trade-off.
Here's a question. How important in the scheme of PGA rankings and all that is the waste management? Because what I'm thinking is this. Why not become the golfer that's drinking while you're playing?
John Daly.
Not a lot.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, John Daly?
He does that.
Yeah.
He smokes cigarettes and drinks, but pays the fine.
Yeah.
Because you're not allowed to drink,
we are
right?
We're not allowed to. Yeah, maybe that'll be a rule we could knock down.
Just for this tournament.
Yeah, just for this tournament.
Like, that's a
when
fair
you get, when you go to Augusta, I've never been, but it's like the hot dogs are still the same price as they were the day they opened. They have like this
domestic
prestige. Yeah, like $1. Only like presidents and like senators can like golf on this place other than pro golfers. Like, why not make the waste management like the ultimate like, fuck you to golf in a way that like takes these younger generations and is like, oh, we want to do this shit. This is awesome.
It's not a terrible, we could have a one-off.
We're innovators.
And drink.
You're just getting hammered while you're playing golf.
Yeah, it's like, do you guys watch The Wire?
I've not seen The Wire.
But I hear it's incredible, dude.
There's so many shows out there now that are amazing. Like Last of Us is now a thing that everyone's watching.
Yeah, but well, The Wire's
old.
Hey, listen.
Old. But they have a thing called Hamsterdam where like in Baltimore they made like you could do drugs in this 1 square mile. You could do whatever you wanted. There was no rules. And like that's what this event should be. It's like, the one place where like we'll turn a blind eye to this.
That's perfect captioning. Max Homa thinks heroin should be allowed.
Yeah.
No drugs.